Welcome back to Let's Play Elder Scrolls Arena. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're in front of Rare Accoutrements. I just sold a bunch of the small things, really. Didn't get a lot of money from those things at all. So that would have been boring for you to watch. But before I go to the Mage's Guild to identify the other things, which I'm very excited about, we're going to repair, or have him repair, our Staff of Strength, which is in a worn condition at this point. Fixing that Staff of Strength is no problem. It'll take 10 days and cost 48 gold. Sound fair? Can't haggle here. Yes, no, or cancel, which is the same as no, I guess. So, what if I say no? Oh. Can't you afford it? Can't you wait that long? Maybe you're not interested. Can't you afford it? I can cut the cost, but it'll take longer. How much gold do you want to spend? It's not that much gold. I'll just take the default arrangement. Yes. Good. I'll get to it as soon as I can. We'll have to remember it's at Rare Accoutrements. Accoutrements. Whatever. Not the other rare store. Not rare merchandise. Rare accoutrements. Mage's Guild. Actually, I need to head that way. I think it's north something? Northwest. Way northwest. We need to identify this stuff. And yet we'll be staying here for 10 days at the inn. So canonically, this adventure took the hero 10 years to do. It took him or her 10 years to find all the pieces of the Staff of Chaos. And this is probably why. Getting your items fixed, traveling across the land, and sleeping in dungeons for days and days. Is this a temple? The Order of the Golden Tomb. And if I spoke to him or someone else at the Order of the Golden Tomb. I have a feeling it might be around here somewhere. Oh, we're kind of close, actually. It's this place. You're just on the wrong side of it. Let's see how expensive it's going to be to identify all this stuff. Two swords, two torques, quite a few things. Detect magic. I can tell you if that is magical. It costs you 751 gold. That's a little pricey. How much money do I have? 1080, okay. That one only costs 76 gold. It is now identified, but also we can look here. Long Sword of Luck. Interesting. Okay, that's identified as well. Long Sword of Paralyzation. That's awesome. I don't know if we can detect anything else. I'm going to sell the two long swords, of course. It's good to know what they are. Another thing I didn't realize, I can actually wear a buckler, but not with this staff, because the staff's two-handed. So, yeah, you can use a buckler and a dagger. So you're plus one in this area. Everywhere else, plus two, like you normally would be. Interesting. So I'm keeping a dagger and a buckler on hand, just in case I need some extra AC. Because some monsters are tough. Of course, that means I will be hitting them for less. But maybe I would default to spells at that point. Okay. What about this torque? We can't afford to detect that. Was that the second one? 75. $93 gold. It's this one. Torque. A dwarven torque. I can just put this stuff on, some of it. I can wear a dwarven torque. Oh, nice! Look at that! Zero armor class. That's amazing. Especially since I'm wearing, default clothes. So it's between the Dwarven Torque, the Mithril Belt, and the Mithril Bracelet. I mean, am I gonna find some kind of mage robe or something like that? That is awesome. Well, I'm definitely keeping the Torque, unless the other one's even better. Now, you could just put the stuff on and find out what it does, but... we wouldn't know all its effects, we wouldn't know exactly what it is. There's gotta be a shop closer. You there, pray wait! Pray wait, good sir, I think. Hey! Hey! Where is the nearest store? I'll check to the west. Alright. Far west. That's not a person. Hey, you! Hey! Hey! Where's the nearest store? Go north for a little while and ask there. How far north? I should just run back to the other store. Alright, my map. Good. Thank you. The basic merchandise. Okay. Alright, so it's basically... around here? Wait, am I headed the right way? No, west and then north. This is actually... west. Okay, so it's in here. Tucked away. Can't imagine you get much business tucked away like this. I like the checkered look. I want to sell you a long sword of paralyzation. Nice! Probably 100 years old, that long sword of paralyzation. I think it still paralyze you real good, mister. 75 11 gold. This is where it gets exciting, because we can counter really high. 900. He's... No, I'm going higher. Wait. Ah! I almost ripped myself off. Wait a second. I have to pay attention to what I'm doing. This is ridiculous. 75, 11 gold, and I was gonna buy it for... Give him what? Did I say 9,000 or 900? Okay. He's gonna... Okay. Let's try 9,000. I'm not sure if that's what I selected. I think I put 900. 8255. Yeah, I put 900. 8255? No. 9,000. Luckily, money doesn't weigh anything in this scheme. 8627. I am insisting on 9,000, sir. Over 9,000! Forget it, maybe I'll compromise at 8813. 8906, close enough. Except. Yes, you can have the longsword of paralyzation, as I cannot use it. Now that's awesome. What about this longsword of luck? 761. This one, say 900. 900. 65 gold. 900. One more time. 900. Accept. Yes. Alright. So I'll find out what these other things do. And now I can. Back to the Mage's Guild. Looking. Where is it? That's what I'm trying to do. I'm missing it somehow. This must be this way. It's northwest, isn't it? Did I? Oh! I didn't see it right under there. I figured it was nearby. Chasing west. Other way. East. Yeah, come out this way. Actually, this way. Here we are. Now I can afford to identify more things. The thing that stinks is that there is no identify spell in the game. Just as there is no mark and recall spell in the game. So you're forever going back to identify things. Until you can figure from the price, like, what they might be. After a while, if you get, like, close to the top-grade equipment, I guess you just end up trying on stuff and see if it improves your armor class. And then just selling it. Right now, I have a genuine interest in what these things are, so... And there's no mark and recall, which leads you have to manually exit all dungeons. But we saw from the first dungeon, it wasn't that bad. From where... We took a really circuitous route to finding that that map. But once we found it, we were just able to go further down the water and then duck into that room, and then we were right by the entrance. Okay. So we want to know what the other toric is. 375 gold, sure. That's identified. That's an adamantium toric. Interesting. What about this bracelet? 37 gold, yes. Alright, let me take a look at these things. What's better, dwarven or adamantium? You think adamantium, wouldn't you? Alright, so... I mean, if that's even better... So we have on dwarven torque switching to adamantium. You can only equip one torque. Well, I'm going to take that off then. Oh my god! I seriously never knew I'd reach negative numbers on a mage character. We have negative 2 armor class. Of course, I don't know if negative 10 is the limit. Like, probably not. Like, in Dungeons & Dragons, negative 10 is a limit. You can't go less than negative 10. Unless something changed in 4th edition and 5th edition. And or 5th edition I didn't know about. I am wondering what the lowest armor class possible in Elder Scrolls Arena is. I'm gonna have to look that up after I'm done. So I have an adamantium torque. Now this doesn't have -4 to armor, I guess AR, armor rating. This doesn't have like a status, like whether it's worn or not. So the light blue is what we're wearing. So elven bracelet, I mean light yellow. Yeah, I know my colors. Elven bracelet, you can only equip one bracelet. Right, so we're down to +1, elven bracelet, 0. Okay, so mithril is better. So we want to go sell the dwarven torque and the elven bracelet. Oh, and we got these bracers too, are magical. Bracers. 438 gold. Yes. Am I broke now? Let me just look at something. Oh, I still have over 9,000. Over 9,000! Okay. This is exciting stuff for me. This is, like, amazing to be at this level, I think. I'm just lucking out by finding this stuff? I'm not sure. I meant to sell the elven helm. I didn't sell it. We will sell it shortly. Bracers of Wizard's Fire. Well, we're wearing them. They don't increase your armor class. But... I guess we can... If we go like this... It has charges, I'm sure. 17 charges of Wizard's Fire. So in case we're low on mana... That's our get out of death free card. No, I do not wish to drop them. Thanks for asking, though. Alright, detecting magic on the mark. 131 gold. Mark identified. Mark of Sanctuary. Mark of Opening. Awesome. We got... Oh, another mark. Find a lot of these things. Fireball! Awesome. I don't know that spell yet. Crystal. What do the crystals do? Crystal of Wanderlight. I guess it's just like a mark. Crystal of Wizard's Fire. Didn't we find some kind of potion, too? I don't see it here. Maybe we died after that. Okay. So Wanderlight has 10 charges, Sanctuary 15 charges, Opening 13 charges. I wonder if it's since, like, if it's like a wand, like as in like a D&D style wand, it has a level associated with it. So the opening level on this, the level on this opening spell might be higher than mine. Or it could be lower. Mine isn't that great, so, because I'm only level 8, I think. 5 charges of fireball. How sad, only that many, but that's great. Crystal Wanderlight, 15 charges. And Wizard's Fire, 11 charges. And the braces have 17 charges. Yeah, I don't know what happened to that potion. I'm guessing that we got it, picked it up, said, ooh, a potion, died in some fight, and reloaded and did not pick up the potion after reloading. That kind of thing happened. So I'm gonna sell the Elven Helm. And Wanderlight. We really need that much Wanderlight. Yeah, we'll go back to this place. So it was like in here, I think? You are very big. Sell the Elven Helm. I'm gonna counter 800. Alright. I'm gonna counter 750. 675 gold. 750. 750. One more time. 750. 740. Close enough, thank you. You are an easy sell. Oops, did I say that out loud? So the Elven Bracelet. $130. I figured that was too high. $120. $120. $120. $118. Okay. I want you to know that this is the most I've ever paid for such an Elven Bracelet. Still ready to sell? Yes. Alright. So, and then, because it doesn't look like these have conditions, like they're new, worn, and stuff, so it looks like you can just have this thing, and that's it. Unless you drop it by mistake, it's yours. Now, we're wearing the, it's probably going to ask me, I just want to make sure. We're wearing the adamantium torque. So we can sell the dwarven torque. The fine dwarven torque. So 35. Counter. Oops. 300. You are crazy. 300. I do think so. 300. 300. I talked you into it, I guess. I don't think there's anything else. We have a lot of wanderlight. We have a mark of wanderlight and a crystal of wanderlight. I don't know if there's anything different as opposed to a crystal. Why is the crystal yellow? Because we're wearing it? I mean, it's showing the other things we're wearing. No, we're not wearing the crystal. Hmm. So you can wear a crystal. And you can wear a mark. Alright. Is it not? It's this building? No, it's gonna be that building. Running back and forth between these places. The music is very atmospheric. Okay, so if I go into buy spells, we'll find out what wanderlight does, right? Creates a globe of light for 5 rounds per level. The light is a projectile. Right. I do remember looking that up now. Choose another spell. Fireball. 1 to 1 points damage health? Okay. I guess then the real damage comes in +4 to 12 points per 1 level. So as you level up. Yeah. I wonder if you can hurt yourself with a fireball. Hopefully not. My balance is 9113. Spell cost is 650. I don't think I can even use that. 650? Okay, spell cost I think is the amount of money. I'm looking for spell points. I have a maximum of 146. Let's see. This fireball. Oh, casting costs 40. Alright. But. A discerning eye for the arcane indeed. You seem to be interested in a fireball. I consider selling it for 650 gold. Counter 500. Shrewd bargainer. Oh, now he'll just agree to 500. Okay. Levitate. I don't have that yet, right? I do have it. What happens if you buy it again? Fire dart, fireball, free action, etc. Well, don't use it on him. That would be bad. Bad idea. Spells. This gives you stamina. This is light. I don't know about wander light. But light lasts a good amount of time. 10 rounds per level. I don't know how long a round is. I will counter 180. I will furthermore counter 180. 180. Okay. We agree then. The light is yours. Eventually, I'll get around to fooling with the spellmaker. I'm not going to be messing with that just yet. Heal. I wonder if it's more efficient. Depends. It's variable. That's the problem. 1 to 15 points to health plus 1 to 5 points per level. And casting cost of 15. That's really variable. So it's anywhere from... I'm level 8. So it's anywhere from... 9... to, 55 points? Between 9 and 55 points. That's crazy. Spell cost... Spell... Casting cost 15. So I don't even have that other spell. He doesn't sell it. The one you start out with. Yeah, get it. Because the other one's light heal, so get this one. That heal is one of my favorites. 250. I will try to get it for 200. 200. 200. Except the Archmage will murder you. I'll attend the funeral. Buy. Orc strength is pretty good. Plus 15 points of strength to caster for 5 rounds per level. Strength loss will occur at a rate of 1 point per 1 round. Okay. So when do you start losing it? After the rounds per level are done, or during it to, like, end out when the rounds are done? I don't know. 250. Oh. No. I was trying to... I hit the wrong thing. Orc strength. Buy. Counter. 200. 200. Alright, he'll accept that. What else? Getting ready for Fang Lair here. Invisibility. Invisible for 5 rounds plus a round per level. So this is fixed. There's no random stuff with that. It's fixed per your level, is what I mean. Invisibility 300. Countering 200, he's not gonna go for it. Obviously you don't have a clue what a quality invisibility is worth. Make me a real offer, I'll just wait until someone smarter comes along. $240? Wait, no. How much were you selling it for? Invisibility. 300. He'll just like, wow. So 200 and he acts like I'm crazy. 240 and it's mine. He won't even. Okay, 220. 260. Yeah, that's weird, isn't it? Did I really hit 240 or did I do something else? Accept. What else? Invisibility is bound to be good to get me past certain monsters, but I'm sure that some monsters will see me or they'll have a chance to see me or something. Shock? Okay, strength lead, shock. 1 to 35 points. It's so variable. I mean, you're talking, at my level 8, you're talking 9 to, what, 75 points of damage? That's true D&D style, though. Completely random. Seems like it could be, it's a wide range of damage. Certain things might be vulnerable to shock. So we'll have a shock thing. Good to have, keep in mind. 450 gold. I was gonna think I'm insane. 300. Yeah. 330. Okay. What else? Free action we got. Resist fire, resist cold. Resist shock. What does sanctuary do? Because we have it on one of our items. 50 designate as non-target. 50% chance caster is ignored. Plus 2% per one level. One round per level, you may not cast other spells. So does that work if the thing's already attacking you? Spell cost 600. Cure poison. Ice bolt spell shield. 50% chance to resist an incoming spell, plus 2% per level. That could be good. I'm just going to show you guys this stuff and I'm going to buy a lot of it off screen. Fireball. We passed all this. Spell shield. Earth wall. Four walls permanently created. Okay. It's like the opposite of the pass wall spell where you can just remove walls. Obviously, there is going to be a limit to how many of these things you can buy. Still have to pay for the inn to stay for 10 days. Heal true. Okay, for some reason I thought heal true was like a complete heal. But it actually, I mean, for a caster, it could be. Plus 25 to 50 points health. Okay, choose another spell. Silence. Witch's curse? Curse target. 30% chance to curse targets. Deteriorations. 1 point intelligence, wisdom, personality, and luck every round. Plus 3% every level. Duration is 1 round per level. That is interesting. This other stuff is obvious. We got an ice destruction spell. Yeah, ice storm, fire storm, wyvern sting is probably like a poison. Yeah, 20% chance to inflict poison. And pass wall, that's the thing. Three walls permanently negated. That doesn't work on all walls. When you get to like later dungeons, there's ones that are like immune to pass wall. But yeah. There's, like, no other dungeon that can do something like that. I mean, there's no other game that can... You can remove walls. It's pretty awesome. Resist poison. Force pitfalls. Okay, you... put pits in the ground. Wildfire. Okay, continuous damage health. Dot spell. Okay. I'm gonna buy a bunch of stuff, and I'll see you guys in a second. I'll let you know everything I've gotten. Okay, I had to look it up about what this this does. I bought a bunch of spells. I'll tell you that in a second. I have 6 potions of restore power. Maybe I should get some healing too. Restore power. I had to look it up just to make sure. Yes, those are mana potions. They give you back, I think, 25 mana each. And cure poison, just in case. I'm out of mana. And these. And I'm poisoned. What about a disease? And then healing. And I bought the following spells. Resist fire, resist cold, resist shock, fireball, cure poison, and spell shield. And I still have 3,600 gold. What about disease? Are there spells for that? Life steal, that sounds good. Yeah, I don't see any cure disease, so how about a potion then, especially? I think there's a what was it, a potion? There's some kind of purification. Cure disease. Give me like 4 of them. They're cheap. They shouldn't weigh anything, right? Poultry sum of 400 gold. How about 300? 300. 300. He agreed to it. Okay. So we got all we want. I'll mess around with the spell raker another time. Sounds awesome though. So we need to do now is stay at the inn. And then go here. And to get our item. Hello. I'm glad they stopped to let you talk to them. Where is the nearest inn? Northeast. We headeth that wayeth. Was that a bush or a small tree or something? It's not an inn, is it? Hello. Where is the nearest inn? Right on my map. Thank you. That's the map of the province. Doesn't help. I mean, continent. That's the name of the inn? Unfortunate Treasure? I guess. In the south. Sounds more like a store. I went past it, I guess? Is it? It's not that. Oh, I'm here. This is an inn? Okay, it doesn't look like an inn that I've seen. The townsmen have met in the unfortunate treasure to celebrate a good fall harvest. In the desert, I guess they're harvesting cacti. Their exuberance is infectious, or palm trees. Oh great, you say to yourself, I'll probably have this stupid drinking song in my head all day. Yeah, probably. Get a room. Single. How many days are you staying? 10. You'll love the single. I'll only charge you 100 gold. A bargain. How about 70 gold for that? It's an absurd offer, and you know it. Kindly make an offer. Make me an offer I could accept. Alright, fine then, 80. Not bad. I'm gonna have to hold my ground at 90 gold. Deal? No, no deal. 80. Alright, fine. 85. I don't believe I'm only charging you 85 gold. You lucky kid. Do we got a deal? Yes. Alright, so now we literally just wait around for 10 days. So that's, I guess, 240 hours? passed. Just like that. We didn't die of starvation either, can you imagine? Oh, we find our way out of here easily. Awesome. Now hopefully our staff is ready. My most prized staff. Like the first major purchase I made was that staff. Rare accoutrements, way down south. And then be ready to go to Fang Lair with my -2 armor class. Watch, it's like nothing. I'm very impressed because I'm thinking of it as D&D terms. For all I know, -40 is like the lowest you can go or something. Alright, where are we now? We're on our way. Seems like it takes as long to travel across this city as, like, from one city to another in Skyrim. Not really, but it kind of seems that way. Okay, so we're gonna head south a bit more and then west. Is this it? Yes. Is my staff ready? Which job do I expect? Okay, status. Staff of Strength. The Staff of Strength is ready. Awesome. Did he give it to me at that point? He did. Okay, good. I wasn't informed he actually gave the thing to me. That's pretty handy because it makes my strength 60. And otherwise be 50. Doesn't it? It's showing the base right here. Right. So we got tons of spells, cool items, and -2 armor class. Next episode, I suppose, we're going to Fang Lair. Go check that out. This is me. I'll keep this as an extra long episode. Just optional, I guess, if you want to see what cool stuff I found and bought and sold and all that stuff. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.